Hello, I'm Dr. Bruce Mathieson. I'm in the biology department at UBC Okanagan campus. We're in the gross anatomy lab at the Southern Medical Program at UBC, and we're lucky because we're going to use brains that have been donated to that program to allow us to dissect through the brain and spinal cord to see structures that are important for our course.
I love teaching about neuroscience, and teaching about the brain is about my favorite thing. The brain's a complicated structure, there's no question about that. And different students have different approaches to learning about the brain. And over the years, I've found that many students struggle with it, partly because they don't have access to something realistic, and they don't have a way to really appreciate not only the three-dimensional structure of the brain, but all of the intricate things inside the brain, because many of them are hidden. Many of them are small. When I teach my students about the brain, they don't have access to real brains. They're not part of the medical school. They're science students, third year or fourth year students. And they have a textbook with a flat piece of paper and maybe a black and white image often. And many times I have scribbled notes on it and arrows pointing to different things with names on them. And I give them this list. Over the years, I've taken this approach. And no matter what I've tried to do, I've found that students have had a hard time really learning how to, part of it's memorize, but also to integrate the three-dimensional structure that they have in front of them with all the different name structures that they need to know for my course. That's the major challenge I have. Fortunately, now we have an opportunity because, well, we have new technology available, plus we also have the Southern Medical Program, which is here, which gives, at least it gives me access to human brain tissue. And that's what I've done with my courses now, to utilize that and put them into a format, video format, and also into a computerized format to allow the students to have whatever the next best thing is to holding a brain in their hand. I definitely see that technology is getting better and more illustrative and more fun for students to use. I think the next step that I want to take in this process is to incorporate into the video and the interactive lab connections to other people's websites. It's a really cool way to incorporate research into just the learning of the structures and the function and the kind of usual didactic stuff that we do.